Mr. Holmes? Mr. Holmes?
It seems that the garden was well maintained.
Inspector Lestrade, when will you remove my husband's body? It's sacrilegious to leave him here like this.
As soon as we can, Mrs. Carey, I assure you. Allow me to introduce you to Mr. Sherlock Holmes. He's a detective. No doubt you've heard of him. I'll wait for you in front of the cabin, Mr. Holmes.
My condolences, Mrs. Carey.
Thank you, Mr. Holmes.
Madam, can you tell me if you saw or heard anything unusual upon the night of the murder?
At 2 o'clock in the morning, I heard a terrible scream. But I thought nothing of it then. He would scream all the time when he was drunk.
Can you please tell me what occurred on the evening of the murder?
Well, Peter got drunk in the evening. He was in such a terrible temper. Usually, whenever that happened, he'd stay all night drinking in his cabin before passing out.
Do you remember at what time you found your husband's body?
In the morning, at around 7 o'clock. I noticed the cabin door was open, but I didn't go in to take a look, for I knew my husband would not have liked it. At around 10 o'clock, I dared to glance in through the door and... Oh, dear...
The garden is very large and well-maintained. Do you employ someone to look after it?
It is true. There is a lot of work, but my husband took care of it himself.
Was your husband accustomed to receiving visitors?
Oh, no, I don't think so. I mean, he didn't really have many friends. He lived quite an isolated life here, after his retirement.
You have indeed suffered a great loss, Mrs. Carey. Nevertheless, I believe it will be less of a burden for you soon.
Yes. Life with Peter was never easy. But he was still my husband.
He was different, wasn't he, when you first met him upon your return from Plymouth?
Yes, Mr. Holmes. Oh, my goodness, but how do you know about that?
You undertook a pilgrimage to the Cathedral of Santiago de Compostela when you were young. That much is evident from the rosary in your hand. The shortest route for the pilgrim from England to Spain is from Plymouth.
I believe that you met Peter Carey as a young sailor there, and you married him soon afterwards.
That is indeed what happened, Mr. Holmes. How extraordinary.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you. These footprints appear to be quite large.
The door is locked.
Wait just a moment, Mr. Holmes, and I'll open it. I locked it yesterday to ensure that no one should enter the cabin and tamper with the evidence.
Ah, good thinking.
Hello, hello, hello.
What is it, Lestrade?
It seems to me that someone has tried to force it, Mr. Holmes.
Let me see.
These scratches are fresh.
You're right. Someone tried to force open the door.
I swear these scratches were not here yesterday.
Now, a mysterious visitor came here last night.
Well, he's not the man for the job. This lock is not a difficult one.
Perhaps he did not have the right tool.
What a terrible way to die. This place is not covered with dust, like the rest of the shelf. An object was taken from here. It was the tooth of a sperm whale, probably from... Dundee. Hammerfest. It's a whaling map. The ship's logs of the Sea Unicorn for the years 1878 to 1884. Peter Carey was her captain. The ship's logs of the Sea Unicorn for the years 18... Peter Carey's boots. They look to be a size 8. Old navigation instruments, nothing interesting. Harpoons for hunting whales. Someone drank from this glass recently. The initials PC have been crudely burned. A sailor's work. This aroma is familiar, but to recognize it, I must construct my associations in one picture.